Good afternoon, children. So let's learn what's a determiner. A determiner is a word that determines the meaning or modifies the meaning of a noun. And in what terms it is done, let's see. It will make the meaning of a noun generic, specific. It will indicate the direction and number of a noun. It will show the possession of a person or a thing. Let's see the examples. Every person has a chance to do something. I have a car. My dog is my best friend. Some people don't give up and these people never fail. This guy is super rich. He has 10 cars. So, all these sentences talks about the possessions, okay? Has, okay? Have, my, these people. So, the text colored yellow is the noun here, okay? And here in the first sentence, every. The word every modify the noun, the person, distributing it, okay? And has a chance. Here we have the determiner a, modifying the noun chance. Now next one, I have a car. Here we have the determiner a. And in case it is making the noun generic, a car, okay? It is specifying the number of cars, a car. Okay, children, the text colored yellow is noun. Next one, my dog is my best friend. My dog, my best friend. The determiner is modifying the noun dog and then it is determiner is modifying the noun best friend. Okay, same word, my. Next example, some people don't give and these people never fail. So here we have the word some, these. Some is a determiner that quantifies the noun people. And this is a determiner that modifies the noun people by indicating the vicinity and its number. Okay, children, so the determiners vary from sentence to sentences and it's a broad idea. Okay, within the single word determiners, you have a lot of sub things to learn. This guy is super rich. He has 10 cars. Here, this guy, we are talking about that particular guy. Here, the determiner, this is used to modify the noun people. Okay, this guy. And he has 10 cars. Okay, how many cars he is having? 10 cars. Okay, children, so the noun car is modified by the word 10. Okay, it is quantifying the noun people. Okay, how many cars he is having 10 cars. Okay, children, now we will be learning in detail each and every determiner. So I hope you have already learned it in the previous classes. So in this class we are just recollecting the main points. Okay, children, so note down the examples. You should learn the points through the examples. Okay, that is how a learning of grammar is very systematic and easy to do. You should learn through the examples. Okay, so I hope the determiners are clear for you. Now let's see the types of determiners. We have articles, possessive or possessive adjective, demonstratives or demonstrative adjective, quantifiers, numbers, distributive adjectives or distributives. So these are the six types of determiners. Okay, children, so we will be dealing with each topic in detail. So you can note down the main points in your notebook. Okay, children, you should know what a determiner is, how it is used, where it is used and all those things. Okay, it's a very important topic. You can have questions from this session for gap filling, editing, omission and everything. It is very important, this topic. Number one, we are going to deal with articles. Okay, children, which are the articles? You know, a and the. Okay, it's a very easy topic. We have the indefinite article a and the definite article the. Okay, so children, when we will use the indefinite article? It is making the meaning of a noun generic and the makes the meaning of a noun specific. When you talk about a particular thing, we use what word? The. Okay, we use the article the when you talk about a specific thing. Example, an apple a day keeps a doctor away. An apple, a cat, a dog. Okay, a general idea. Now let's see the example of the article the. So as I have told you, it talks about the specific thing. Okay, the movie that we watched yesterday was awesome. So we are talking about the movie that we watched yesterday. Okay, we are specifying if that particular movie that we watched yesterday was awesome. Okay, children, so you can note down the example and copy down these points in your notebook as you are listening to the video. Okay, children, so I hope you are thorough with what an article is. We have indefinite article a and definite article the, and we use a and for making a noun generic or generalizing, and we have the word the for specific things. Okay, so where you use a is it's very common before consonant sound, and we use and before the vowel sounds. Okay, children, so we have the determiners, articles, and a and the. Now next one, I watched a movie yesterday and that was awesome. Okay, so here we are not saying a particular movie, we are just saying I love the girl who is wearing a red top. Okay, that particular girl wearing the red top, I love that girl. Okay, so children, very often the is replaced by a or an, but if you want to show particularity, you should use the word the itself. So read the sentence completely well and then only you can insert the word a, an, or the. So next, we are going to do something interesting. Take out a book or a newspaper, open a page, look at a paragraph and find out all the singular countable nouns the paragraph has. Okay, children, you can make use of a paragraph from your textbook even, okay? You can take out a book or a newspaper and you can have a paragraph and note down the singular countable nouns. Okay, children, the nouns that will be preceded by a or an. Very easy exercise that I have given for you. Try to do it, okay, children? Now, next we are moving on to some important points, okay, children? So, there are some important points that you should take care of. Determiner always comes before a noun it modifies. A determiner always comes before a noun it modifies. A singular countable noun has to be modified with an appropriate determiner. A singular countable noun has to be modified with an appropriate determiner. So, 2 points we have learned already. Okay, children, very easy points. You should remember these points when you are preparing for your grammar exams. Okay, children, the grammar part is having MCQs. So, you should keep these small things in your mind. Example, my father is doctor. My brother is engineer. I have car. It's wrong. Okay, children, these usages are wrong. You will only say that my father is a doctor. My brother is an engineer. I have a car. Okay, children. So, the correct usage is my father is a doctor, my brother is an engineer, and I have a car. Okay, so a singular countable noun has to be modified with an appropriate determiner. Now, the third point. A determiner always comes before an adjective in a noun phrase. A big boy, some amazing places, your beautiful wife. So, here you have determiner plus adjective plus noun. So, a determiner always comes before an adjective in a noun phrase. Okay, children. So, what will be the structure? Determiner plus adjective plus noun. Now, next we are going to learn possessives. My, your, his, her, their, our, its. So, all these words are possessives. Now, let's learn. Possessive adjectives are used to show a possession of a noun. Okay, if you are possessing something, use possessive adjectives. My goal is to help people achieve their goals. She does not love her job. Okay, my goal, you're talking about your goal. Okay, their goals, her job. Okay, all these things are examples of possessives. Okay, children, so the words are by, your, his, her, their, our, its. Learn these words, okay? Then you will not be confused how to do this determiners. You should be thorough with these words, okay? So possessives are just possessive adjectives that show the possession of a. Okay, children, here we have the goal, okay? Goal is a aim. And my goal, okay, she's talking about her goal, to help people, noun, people achieve their goals, okay. Now, she does not love her job also. We have the possession. She is possessing a job. That is why it is said she does not love her job. We are not talking about anybody else's job. We are talking about her job, okay. She is talking about her job. Okay, children, so we are moving forward to demonstratives. So number three, you have demonstratives. So which are the demonstratives, children? This, that, these, those. Okay, tell it after me. This, that, these, those. Demonstratives determine a noun by showing its number and vicinity. Okay, its closeness. Nearness, okay, its number, how many numbers it is, and its vicinity, its closeness or nearness. This guy is super talented. This guy, okay, this guy means you are standing near to him. I love that girl. I love these girls. I love those girls. It is just showing the nearness. Okay. Singular and far away from the speaker, okay. So, the girls are, they are singular and she is far away, okay. This means you are near, okay. Singular and close to the speaker. So, determiners. This, singular number, it is close. That word means that the object is close, the noun is close. That means it is singular in number and the noun is far. And these and those indicate plural. And this means the noun is close to him, and those means the noun is standing far away from him. Okay, children. So the vicinity means the nearness or how far it is the noun is from you. Now next we have the quantifiers. Any, some, few, a few, the few, many, a lot of, lots of, little, a little, the little, several. Okay. So children, these are the quantifiers. Okay. So actually we have a lot of confusions in the usage in particularly in this sessions, okay, as we have a lot of quantifiers, we will get somewhat confused. Now let's see how it is used, okay, what is the variation and how it is used and all those things we are going to learn now. Example, some people never give up. Many innocent people lost their lives in the riots happened last week. I have a few students to teach. Okay. So here some people means some are there. Okay. Many innocent people. That here there you have the quantifier many. Now I have a few students. Okay. A few means some students she is having to teach. Now in the first sentence you have the determiner some. Second sentence you have many determiners. Many, there, the. But the quantifier is many. Okay. There is the possessive and the is the article. Okay, children. So, you should be able to identify a determiner, whether it is a quantifier, whether it is a possessive adjective and all those things. Okay. So, after listening to this video, you will be able to understand this surely. I have a few students to teach. Here, a few means it's a positive number. Okay. Some students are there. Okay, it doesn't mean that she is not having anybody to teach. Okay. A few means it's positive sense. Okay. A few, some gives a positive connotation, but few, almost nothing, gives a negative connotation. Okay. Few students means nobody is there. A few means some students are there. Okay, children. So it's a very often confused usage, a few and few. Please note it down in your notebook and learn it thoroughly.
Quantifiers used with uncountable nouns. Okay, children. So, which are the quantifiers used with uncountable nouns? Little, much, enough, a large amount of. Okay, children. So, which are the quantifiers used with uncountable nouns? Little, much, enough, a large amount of. Let's see the examples. I got little milk in my fridge. Okay, some milk is there. She doesn't not have much energy left to talk to you. Okay, the required energy is not there. That is what you will mean by the usage much energy. Now listen here. Note the point. Little means almost nothing. Gives a negative connotation. A little means something is there. Okay. It gives a positive connotation. Okay, like we learned, a few is positive, a little is positive, but little and few is negative, means nothing is there. Okay, children, please note that point. Little, almost nothing, a little means something. Now, next one, she doesn't not have much energy. Okay, here the determiner is much. And it's a quantifier that is used with uncountable nouns. You can't count energy, right? Now, next one is numbers. Okay, let's see how the determiners are indicated in numbers. We have cardinal and ordinal. Okay, cardinal we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But in ordinal we have 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th. It is rather easy to remember, isn't children? Okay. This series has 8 episodes. 8 is cardinal. He has got 40 people working for him. Again, it's cardinal. Life doesn't give you a second chance. Your second is a ordinal. This is my 5th interview this month. So, 5th is an ordinal. So, children, note this point. You can just write numbers and write the point as cardinal and ordinal. Okay, children, you can even write two or three examples so that you may easily remember what you have learned in this session. Okay, children, in the sentence, life gives you a second chance, you should remember you have a, which is an article. Okay, so both two determiners can come together. It is not that only one determiner will be there. Okay, this is my 5th interview this month. We have my, 5th, this. 3 determiners are there. My is a possessive adjective, 5th is an ordinal number, and this is a demonstrative adjective. Okay, so in a sentence, you may have 3 or 4 determiners. It is not limited to a number. Okay, so you should be able to identify which are the determiners used in a certain sentence. Now, 6th one, we have the distributive adjectives. Which are they? Each, either, neither, all, both, every. Okay, children, so the distributive adjectives are each, either, neither, all, both, every. A person, either, boy, all people. Each girl deserves an award. All people are capable to do evil things. Neither girl is entering into the class. Now, we have multiple determiners in a noun phrase. As I have told you, there will be 3 or 4 determiners in a noun phrase. Okay, let's have a look at it. Structure of a noun phrase is determiner plus adjective plus noun. For example, a beautiful lady, some crazy people, these smart people. Now, the order is articles or possessives or demonstratives plus number plus adjective plus noun. That is the next sentence pattern. My 4 sisters, the 4 boys, these 2 boys. Here we have the pattern articles or possessive or demonstratives plus number plus adjective plus noun. Okay, children. So, just copy down these structure patterns. Okay. It will come in such a structure in a sentence, the multiple determiners. Okay, children. So, you have to give the heading structure of a noun phrase and write these 2 points with 1 example each. That is good. You can remember the points. So, please note, we can't have a combination of determiners amongst articles, possessives and demonstratives. The, my, this car,
all these things are wrong. Okay. So let's recollect the points that we learned, children. So what we learned today, we learned determiners. Okay. So the grammar topic that we learned today is determiners. Determiners are words which come at the beginning of the noun phrase. Okay. We have articles, demonstratives, possessives, quantifiers. Now articles, okay, articles. How we can use articles as determiners? Which are the articles we learned, children? A and the. Okay, we have indefinite articles and definite articles. Now, when do we use indefinite articles? Indefinite articles are A and the. The noun it goes with is indefinite or general. A or an is used with indefinite or general. I have a book. Any kind of book it is. Okay, children. And A is always comes before a consonant sound. An animal. Here, an comes before a vowel sound. But exceptional cases are there. An hour. Okay, an hour. We have to go for the sound, not the letter. Okay, an hour. Okay. Now, next, we are moving on to the indefinite article, the. Okay, we learned about indefinite. Now, next one is definite article. It indicates a specific thing. I sat on the chair. It refers to a particular or specific chair. I sat on a chair means refers to any kind of chair. Okay, next we have the demonstratives. Okay, we learned about demonstratives. They are this, that, these and those. Okay, children. So, demonstratives are depending on the number and the vicinity. Okay, demonstratives. They are to be replaced a noun. Okay, demonstratives. We have pronouns which replace a noun and they modify a noun. This camera is mine. This is my camera. Okay, here the noun camera. We are talking about the noun camera. Okay. And this is used as a determiner, okay? And in the second sentence, this is my camera. It is showing a possession. Now, possessives, okay? We also learned about what possessives, okay? So, what's a possessive? It's also a determiner. And we have possessive pronouns also. It precedes the noun, the thing being possessed. This is my house, okay? The house is possessed by me, okay? Is that car yours? Okay, if you are asking the question, is that car yours? Here it's a possessive pronoun. Okay, children, does the car belongs to you? Now, the next one is quantifiers. Those were derived from the indefinite pronouns that tell us how many or how much. Okay, quantifiers tells us how many or how much. Okay, we have the non-countable nouns, much less, a large amount of, a little, little. Then we can use both. For countable and non-countable nouns, we have a lot of, lots of, more, most, some, any. And for countable nouns, we use many, few, a few, a large number. Okay, children, so draw this column in your notebook. It is very, very much helpful for you when you prepare for your exam, the grammar part. All these things are very small things, but very important, okay? You may make some minute mistakes as the questions are in MCQ. You may get confused by seeing the lot of options. So, children, keep this in mind, okay? Example, Tashnada has a little experience in management. That means she's having some experience, okay? It's wrong. Okay, Tashnada has little experience in management. Okay, children, so we have learned the usage of... Charlie owns a few books. Okay, a few means few books are there. Okay, if few only comes means nothing is there. Okay, so you should very well be thorough with the meanings of these usages. Now, next coming to some and any. Okay, where you will use some, any. Okay, that's also a much confusing things. When you have something in a positive statement, you will use some. And if nothing is there, you will use the word any, okay? For affirmative sentences, positive sentences, we use some. And for negative sentences, you use any.